Welcome to another episode of PTV. I'm Royce Turner.
And I'm Haley Bruner. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears.
I've come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. Yes, I remember those lines from Mrs. Pockenberry's English class.
Well, the tradition continues. Reika Kumira tells more on this story.
Friends, Panthers, and fellow sophomores, it's time for Caesar memory work.
So every year in English 2, we have an assignment when we read Julius Caesar to do some memory work. And the main purpose of doing some memory work is to kind of have an appreciation for the fact that actors have to memorize a lot of lines in a play. When we read Julius Caesar, it's not like reading a novel. It's reading a play. And so plays really aren't meant to be read, they're meant to be performed. So giving students an opportunity to memorize a certain passage just helps them understand how, you know, difficult it is sometimes to memorize lines and be able to perform them.
Friends, Romans, Christians, lend me your ears.
I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him.
The evil that men do lives after them.
The good is oft interred with their bones.
So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you Caesar was ambitious.
If it were so, it was a grievous fault.
And grievously hath Caesar answered it.
Well, actually, I'm kind of a procrastinator, so I haven't been working on it for a super long time yet. But anytime I got little spare moments, I'd go and I'd look at it.
And that whole passage is about 36 to 40 lines. Now, if they don't memorize the whole thing, if they only get through like the first 8 lines, they can do that. If they do it perfectly, they can still get a C grade for that. If they get through the first, I believe it's 18 lines, and they get a B grade. They have to get through 26 lines, I believe, for an A grade, and if they do the whole thing, there's some extra credit opportunities. Last year, I made a deal with my students that if every single English 2 student got at least a C grade, I'd bring donuts. And so I decided I'd give that same offer to this year's English 2 students, and I think we'll get there.
Previous English 2 students still remember most of their memory work.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears.
I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him.
The evil that men do lives after them. The good is oft interred with their bones. So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you that Caesar was ambitious. If it were so, it was a grievous fault, and grievously hath Caesar answered it.
Here under leave of Brutus and the rest, for Brutus is an honorable man, so are they all honorable men. And that's all I got.
For PTV, this is Reika Kimura.
Some students got a late start on that memory work because they couldn't access it on Google Classroom because of some iPad issues.
In this next story, we found out what happened and how students and teachers had to adjust while the iPads were out of commission.
Recently, students and teachers had to set aside their iPads as an updating issue caused most iPads in the school district to be unable to connect to the internet. According to Mr. Moon, the technology coordinator, the problem occurred when a miscommunication happened with the company that provides internet security to the school. This issue meant that many teachers had to go with Plan B for a few days until the issue was solved.
We do use iPads quite often for everything from doing grammatical type things, no red ink, to doing worksheets on Google Classroom, and even interacting with like some online games. So the iPad crash was kind of detrimental to classroom activity. I did have to change my plans around kind of at the last second, so it took a little bit of thinking, but instead of taking notes on the iPads like we normally do, I just projected it onto my screen, and then the kids wrote on paper. Or instead of doing the little activity that was online, we just kind of had to all look up and use my computer because that was the only working one. So we got it figured out and we were productive, but it just took a little bit of extra thinking.
In the process, students learned the lesson of how important it is to back up their files because the iPads had to be completely wiped in order to get them working again.
We could not get on the internet. We cannot get emails. I was fine with it. Until my iPad got wiped because it was last backed up at the beginning of December.
I couldn't even open the app. It wouldn't even open the app. I couldn't even attempt to try to do my homework. And like I said, it was a major setback to start the year.
For PTV, this is Haley Bruner.
Join us for Fun with Helium. I'm Angela Khan. I'm a senior.
I'm Jackson Horn, and I'm a sophomore.
My name is Mackenzie Martin, and I'm a junior.
My name's Nate Meekler, and I'm a senior.
Planning can get hectic for teachers when technology fails, but student aides can often lessen the load for teachers. Here's more on what student aides do at PHS.
Have you ever wondered how a teacher gets all those tasks done in such a short amount of time? Say hello to the student aide.
I'm student aide for Mrs. Pinkerton. I just like make copies of stuff, run errands for her. I file the music, make posters and stuff for amendment, compose dances, all that kind of stuff. Mrs. Pinkerton was new, and so I decided that I should probably help her out a little bit because I know a lot about the group and a lot about what we do.
I am student aide for Mrs. Miller. Usually I make copies, fill the vending machine, do anything that she really asked me to. Those are the normal. I thought it'd be fun, and it's kind of nice to just have a free class period and help do that stuff. I like to do that type of stuff, so it's fun. I always liked her as a teacher, and I really wanted to just be hers because she's nice and has me do fun stuff.
Well, there's always those things that are difficult to do in the course of a daily teacher's routine, and having somebody 1 hour that can just devote herself to those things really helps. You know, there's those copies that we don't get done, or that thing delivered to the office that we don't get done, and so it's nice to have somebody to be able to do that.
Along with helping teachers, it gives students an extra hour for flexible scheduling.
It's a class utilized to help teachers out with running copies and just anything teachers may need in general. We use seniors to do that. And, you know, it helps with flexibility of scheduling, too.
It benefits me a lot. She's very flexible and willing to help. And so anything that I can't get done in my planning time, she's able to then get finished for me, or she's able to do the things that take more time but not necessarily are that difficult. So it saves me a lot of time that I can use to better prepare for my classes.
For PTV, this is Royce Turner.
To learn more about cattle, some FFA members attended the Denver Stock Show and had some fun too.
The Phillipsburg FFA traveled to Denver, Colorado for the Stock Show.
My favorite part was all the lighting and the fireworks and watching the Cowboys ride, because it's plenty different than ours, and it was good.
During the trip, students went skiing and also visited the zoo.
I thought it was a cool zoo, had lots of activities, had lots of things, lots of information. So I don't know that I really can say anything was my favorite part, but there was a lot of neat activities, a lot of neat animals at the zoo.
The elephant chew, I love their little nose, it was like...
For PTV, this is Danica Hanchett.
More fun with helium! Oh my gosh, I just love Justin Bieber. He's my boyfriend. I dream about unicorns and rainbows every night. Tacos are my favorite food.
Oh my God, I like Taylor Swift.
Oh yeah, I have a dinosaur and his name is Fred.
I like brushing my teeth with mustard.
Ew, I hate mustard.
January is a time of year when many people start getting into shape at the start of the new year.
Some choose dancing as a means of exercise. That's what several did this year at the Pacer Dance-Off. Natalie Hughes has this story.
The Phillipsburg Pacers hosted a dance-off to raise money for their dance team.
My friend Tammy Sauer and I came up with it a few years ago. We just wanted to do something different than go door-to-door, so we wanted to do some activity, and we love to dance, so that's how we came up with it.
My favorite routine we did today was called Milk Money. It was kind of a hip-hop dance, and it was just really fun to get into it.
Supporters paid $10 for a t-shirt and a chance to dance along with the Pacers and get a variety of fun exercise.
I like cardio, toning, fast, slow, anything.
The
word. I've participated in this for 2 years.
Preparing for this event takes a lot of effort.
Just watching a lot of instructors and memorizing the dances and practicing a lot.
For PTV, this is Natalie Hughes.
This week, we got the text alert that all students and probably teachers love to receive.
No school for USD 325 due to inclement weather.
Sam Pruitt tells us more about the ice in the berg. Get it?
Students got a nice surprise with no school on Monday due to the weather.
On snow day, I slept until 9:30, and then East Side just kind of hung out all day and we baked cookies.
I stayed at home and played PS4 for most of the day. I almost fell when I walked out of my house because there's still ice on our driveway.
My parents thought it would be too icy to go out, but after that I kind of went out and had some fun in the ice and slid around a little bit.
Although it was fun for students, it was work for others.
Monday afternoon, put salt on the sidewalks, clear the sidewalks off, scraped a bunch of ice off. Checked all the furnaces, heaters, make sure everything's working there fine. Did nothing froze up. Other than that, there's not a lot we can do with ice. On Monday morning, the roads weren't as bad as I thought they would be. During the day Monday, I really thought we were going to have more trouble Tuesday.
It was still really icy and sugared, so we had to take it pretty slow, but the highways were clear. My car is still buried under ice.
got home from school, I was walking inside, tired from basketball practice, and I took about one step out of my truck and I almost fell, and I think that I kicked 7 foot in the air, but I managed to stay on my feet, so.
For PTV, this is Samantha Pruitt.
Cold winter days are a good time to stay indoors and play board games with the fam.
In this next report, Camry Stegmeyer tells us about a familiar game with a local twist.
Have you ever wanted to own a business in Phillipsburg? It may be easier than you think. With one roll of the dice, you can own any business from Tamco to Coombs Trucking when you play Phillipsburgopoly, a new board game based on our hometown.
We decided to make Phillipsburgopoly because it was just a fun game, I thought. They sent us a sample and from Pineburg, and it looked really neat, and so I went around and just got different people to buy spots for the board. First I emailed them, and then they bought the spots, and so that's why not everyone's on there.
Give me that baby for a buck!
The game is based on the original Monopoly game, but instead of passing go to collect $200, you go to Kansas' biggest rodeo and forget jail. You'll have to go to the ER instead.
We've sold close to 400.
For PTV, this is Camry Stegmeyer.
More fun with helium! Stay classy, Phillipsburg High.
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 Speaking of games, it's time for a sports report with Tanner.
After a long Christmas break, the Phillipsburg wrestlers were ready to take to the mats again when they traveled to Superior, Nebraska for a tournament. Caleb Reed has that report.
The wrestling team traveled to Superior for a wrestling tournament. To start the day off, Josh Langer gets another terrific pin. After that, Kurt Coombs easily gets a pin. Later on, Mark Coombs has a scuffle, but ends up the victor. During the semis, Sisson fights off his back to get a pin. During the finals, Aaron Linker is victorious.
I think that some of us came out a little bit slower, but that's probably meant to be because we had such a long break in regular competition. And then towards the end, we started winning matches that we should have won, and we came out with a few medal places, so that's pretty good.
There was success in more than one area.
I think it's good for our whole entire team to get experience. I think Cole Wenzel hadn't had a match until today, and that was good for him to get a few in along with our varsity and JV wrestling together at the same tournament. It was a good experience because then we could bond together. Smith Center was also here, and they did really well as a team, and we also did well. You know, I think each state respectively has their own very good wrestlers.
For PTV, this is Caleb Reed.
Good luck to our wrestlers as today and tomorrow they compete at the Bob Kuhn Classic in Hayes. Our basketball teams finally got a chance to play on our home court again last week when we hosted the Smith Center Redmen. Take a look at how those games went.
The Lady Panthers took on their rival Smith Center on Tuesday, January 10th.
We played really good for three quarters, and then we just gave the game away in the fourth quarter. Too many turnovers, just bonehead plays.
The girls started off strong, but ran into trouble in the second half.
Just handled the pressure a lot better. We didn't execute any of our press breakers, and gave them the ball too many times and an opportunity for them to go to the basket.
I can improve on keeping my head up, dribbling down the court, and looking for my teammates.
Rebounds. I think I could have gotten a little more rebounds in. Probably did a little bit or better defense.
The girls were very optimistic before the game.
Before the game, I felt really good. I felt like we were ready to play. You know, finally had a home game. We haven't had a home game in a while, and just had some good vibes. And like I said, we put three quarters in and just didn't finish the deal.
Nervous. That is one word for it. I was nervous coming to the game and knew it was going to be tough. Tough game.
I was very nervous, but I came out with a good attitude, hoping to win.
The girls gave it their all during the Smith Center game.
I thought I did pretty well coming into the game today, and I thought I controlled my emotions very well out on the court.
Well, we came into this game knowing it was going to be a tough one, but we did pretty well.
For PTV, this is Ethan Fike.
The basketball boys got a hard-earned victory against Smith Center.
Well, tonight we played Smith Center. We had a good win tonight. Come out and played well, got a big lead, and we had a lot of guys play. We suited up 14, and we got 13 guys in the game. Royce Turner, only senior, got 2 points tonight, so it was a good win for the whole team.
Smith Center's pressure didn't manage to break the Panthers.
I thought with Smith Center's pressure, we handled it pretty well. We had some turnovers, but for the most part, we got a lot of easy baskets. We missed a lot of layups, but that's going to happen sometimes when you're trying to go too fast. But I thought we played reasonably well.
Well, we just played great defense against them, so they weren't able to score as much as we could.
I thought we were in a lot better shape than they were, ran the court well. That was what helped us win the game.
They definitely managed to give it home this home game.
I was kind of worried for the game with the kids having maybe a little letdown after beating Plainville and Beloit, two good teams. And Smith Center is a solid team. There's the record-wise, they're not as good as with the other ones we have. But we're at home, and we don't play at home very much. Smith Center is our second game at home, so the guys are ready to play tonight.
Just love playing Smith Center, league team. Tough games.
For PTV, this is Tanner Cole. Panthers competed in another MCL game as they went to Norton last Friday. Alicia Hernandez has that report.
With the return of Tatum Bartels and Alexi Beach to the lineup, the Lady Panthers had high hopes for defeating Norton, but it was senior Hannah Hoover who stepped up with the big game. Here she takes the ball the length of the court and cashes in the layup. Then, later in the first half, Hoover scores again when she's fouled on the three-pointer. She then makes the and one for a four-point play. In the second half, Alexi Beach helps out with a long two-point bucket. Hannah Hoover stayed hot and drains another three-pointer. Hoover was 5-for-5 from the field with a total of 14 points. Bartels added 12 points and 8 rebounds, but costly turnovers hurt the Lady Panthers, and Phillipsburg loses 31-51.
Tonight was my first night back since my knee surgery, and I thought it went pretty good. I was like double teamed a lot, and so it was kind of hard, but my guards like picked it up and they did really well on their kickout shots. Just, we wanted to get a win and we didn't get that, unfortunately, but we're looking for a win against Oakley tomorrow.
For PTV, this is Alicia Hernandez. Phillipsburg faced number one ranked Norton for an MCL matchup last Friday. The Panthers were ready to battle as Nathan Moon draws the charge against Norton's Jace Reuter. And to end the first half, Trey Thompson finds Van Kuen on the backside to give the Panthers a 31-30 lead. The second half continued to be as close as the first, and Jordan Ford gets the jumper for another 2 points. Norton made a run, and early in the fourth quarter, the Panthers trailed by 12, but fought back with the help of this play where Van Kuen finds Trey Sides for the bucket and foul. The Panthers came with 2 points, but time ran out and the Panthers lost.
I was proud of the guys. I thought everybody stepped it up a notch and did some good things. Just unfortunately, we didn't come out with the win, but they're a good team and they'll make us better by the game tonight.
Well, we fought pretty hard, but we didn't come out with a W. Get them next time.
We're coming into the game against a very good team. I mean, you're always hoping to win the ball game, and you always want to compete. And I thought our guys competed well. Just didn't have enough down the stretch. Make a shot here and there, and it's a different ball game. And sometimes you get a call here and there, a roll on a crib shot that we missed, a few of those, get those to roll in, and we would have won the ball game. So, and we'll see him again later in the year, so we'll be ready for him.
It was a good learning experience since we're so young, and I hope we'll be able to beat him soon this year.
For PTV, this is Alicia Hernandez.
And on Tuesday, our boys team overcame a 16-2 first quarter deficit and beat the Ellis Railers by 1 point to advance to the MCL tournament semifinals. Phillipsburg will play TMP tonight for a chance to play in the finals tomorrow. Good luck. That's all for sports. Now back to Royce and Haley.
Thanks, Tanner. Now it's time for a fun feature, which strangely reminds me of trips to the dentist. Take a look.
All I saw is vegetables.
Say that again.
The last one is vegetables.
My last son eats vegetables.
Ooh, pretty close. The last one eats vegetables.
Velociraptor eats vegetables.
You got it, sir.
There's like that.
Principal pass.
Principal pass?
There's like X.
Something right X.
Airs.
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 Bears make right.
Ow.
Flap.
Rake. Deer.
Are you saying deer or there? Bear?
Bear.
Bear take baths?
Rake. Rack.
Rake wax?
I don't know if I like that. Her right now.
No clue.
Article Floyd and her right now.
I don't
know. I see her on
biologist loves beautifully.
Biologist must, I don't know.
Roast beautifully. You got to get this.
Velociraptors. Eat.
Velociraptors eat vegetables.
Yay!
That wraps up another episode of PTV. I'm Haley Reiner.
And I'm Royce Turner.
Stay classy, Phillipsburg High.